Today let us begin the new chapter application of derivative. In that we will begin the topic increasing or decreasing function. In this topic there may be two type of question. First type, state or prove that the given function is increasing or decreasing. Second type may be find out the interval in which the function is increasing and the function is decreasing. Okay, it's given that y is equal to x plus 4. Y we can write f of x is equal to x plus 4. Y we can write f of x also. We know that the equation of a straight line, it is a linear equation. So linear equation, the graph of the linear equation always will be straight line. So equation of a straight line will be y is equal to mx plus c, which means m is 1, which means tan theta equal to 1 is 1. So which means here tan 45. So for 45 angle the slope is, this 1, which means it will make the 45 degree with the x axis. Okay, so the equation of line will be this. It will turn 45 degree. Okay, if the equation is given y equal to x plus minus x plus 4 or minus x plus 3. Okay, equation is given minus x plus 3, then here n or m is equal to, if we compare with the y is equal to mx plus c, so m equal to, this will be tan theta equal to minus 1, because slope is minus 1, which means 1 means tan 45, but negative, due to negative it will be 90 plus 45, means 135. So when the angle is 135, then this will be, slope will be like that. Slope will be this, 90 plus 45, it will be 135. So the equation of this will be like this. Okay, why? Because when we will put x equal to 0, so y equal to 3, and it will turn in this direction, it will rotate in this way. Okay, now you know that here x is increasing, so y is also increasing. Here f of x is also increasing. When x is increasing, y is also increasing, or f of x is also increasing, then it is called increasing function. Here x is increasing but y is decreasing, or f of x is decreasing. When x is increasing, y is decreasing, f of x is decreasing. In this situation we can say that the function is decreasing. This function is decreasing. Means it's clear that when x is increasing, the function f of x is also increasing. Then we can say that the function is increasing. When x is increasing but the f of x is decreasing, in that situation we can say that function is decreasing. But what about this sine function is given? Suppose f of x is equal to sine x is given. You know sine 0, 0, sine 90, pi by 2 will be 1. Because sine value always will be between minus 1 and 1. Okay. So at pi by 2, this will be 1, highest. Okay. Then again pi, at pi this will be, then at 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2. That will be, this will be, then 2 pi, then like that, again it will increase. This is the sine function. So here we will talk about the interval for this interval 0 to pi. Here we will talk in the interval only, 0 to pi. If in the 0 to pi interval, if I will ask to you, the sine function is increasing or decreasing, so you will say that 0 to pi it is increasing and pi by 2 to pi it is decreasing. So such function is called neither increasing nor decreasing. Such function is called neither increasing nor decreasing. Or we can say that if I will talk about this interval 0 to pi by 2, close interval 0 to pi by 2, close interval 0 to pi by 2. So here if we'll I'll draw here. Draw here, from here to here, if I will check 0 to pi by 2, between 0 to pi by 2 I have to check f of x is equal to sine x, this function. So if we will draw here tangent, we can draw here, and at this point the tangent will be parallel to x axis, means it will be constant. At 0 also it will be constant. Okay, so in the close interval, in the close interval 0 to pi, I can say that the function is only increasing. Function is only increasing. The function is increasing. This function is increasing. Why? Because here f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. Here 0 also you can get here. At 0 if you say, here the means here slope of a tangent is f dash of x. Slope of a tangent is f dash of x. Derivative, which is called derivative also. Slope of a tangent, if you draw the tangent of this of this function, so you will get that it is increasing only. This function, it will be increasing. But at this point, it will be constant. At this point, at 0, it will be constant. It is parallel to x axis. Even at pi by 2, because it is closed into, even in the pi by 2 also, it will be parallel to x axis. Means we can say that it may be increasing or it will be equal to 0. It will be equal to 0. It will be constant. So in that situation, we can say that the function is increasing. Function is increasing for this closed interval 0 to pi by 2. Or if I will talk about this interval pi, if I will talk about pi by 2 to pi, so you can say that the here also, if you draw the tangent here, we will draw the tangent at every point of this slope, graph. So you will notice here that at this pi by 2, because close intervals are at this pi by 2, the function f dash of x will be 0 here, f dash of x equal to 0 here in this point, at this point. Even that pi also, the f dash of x equal to 0. Okay. And here in between this pi by 2 to pi, you will get to know that the slope of a tangent will be decreasing. Means f dash of x is less than or equal to 0. Less than or equal to 0. So we can say that the function is decreasing. Function is decreasing for interval, close interval minus pi by 2 to pi. Minus pi by 2 to pi. Now, if this sine function only, this is pi by 2, this is pi, this is 0. If you draw your tangent, this is 0. But if I will ask about the open interval 0 to pi by 2, open interval excluding 0 to pi by 2, so this function, when the f dash of x will be 0, at 0 and pi by 2, we have excluded this, means between this point to this point, the function is, the slope of a tangent is always positive, means f dash of x is always greater than 0. When f dash of x is always greater than 0, then the function is called the strictly increasing. Strictly what we will use? Strictly increasing. Or if you talk about the minus pi by 2 to pi, the function will be open interval. In the open interval pi by 2 to pi, the tangent, the slope of a tangent always will be at every point of the function of the graph, the slope of a tangent will be decreased. Okay, so it means f dash of x is less than 0. So you can say that the function is strictly decreasing. Strictly decreasing. So everyone got it? What? If the function, when f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0, then the function is increasing. When the f dash of x is less than or equal to 0, the function is decreasing. And when the f dash of x is only greater than 0, then we can write that in it is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. And when f dash of x is less than 0, then we write strictly decreasing. Okay, so let's see one question on this